about that.
Good evening, everybody. Nice to see you. Hi there. My name is Stu Warshauer. It is my privilege and pleasure to join the assistant principals here at Heriton. And on behalf of the administration and the faculty and all the wonderful children, it's my pleasure to welcome you to the Winter Choral and Jazz Concert. So tonight, let me tell you about what you will be hearing. Tonight we'll feature the concert choir, the vocal ensemble, Pitch Trees, which is our student-led a cappella group, and the jazz band. The symphony orchestra will also be featured in the choir. Public service announcement at this time, please silence your cell phones. And one last word from me. It's really awesome to see such a big crowd here. I don't know if there's any joy that is greater than watching your child or grandchild or nephew or niece or family member perform. So please join me in welcoming Mr. Bizich, our music teacher and choral director.
To you the 2023-2024 edition of the Heriton Concert Choir. Thank you very much. I'd also like to welcome you to the Heriton. Raise your hand if this is the first time attending one of our concerts today. Well, a special thank you, a special welcome to you, and a special welcome to our live stream audience. So we have a three-camera shoot. And they told me I'm to welcome everybody over here. Hello, if you're at home, we'd like to give you a special welcome too. Never really prepared for TV, though I let you try it sometime. So a special welcome to our live stream audience, and a very special welcome to actually my best friends, Courtney and Lucas Ford, drove all the way out here from Pittsburgh. Can you imagine? Just to be here for this concert. I'm not sure I've ever driven 270 miles to attend a concert, but they're here tonight, and I appreciate you guys being here. So, on to the music, right? So, we've been exploring a lot about color in music and expression, and how music can imitate real life, and how music can help us process the events of life. So, no two pieces, no two notes should sound alike tonight. That's what we're going for. The first two pieces are in Latin. The first one is a Gloria. It's in ABA form, so it's going to be three distinct sections. The first one will repeat. The color of the first section is like, it's like a vibrant color. You'll hear it when the choir sings Gloria Excelsis. The B section takes on a more, oh, like a watercolor kind of tone, and it becomes more ethereal. The Dies Irae is a 13th century chant, and it's in a minor key, and it's highly dissonant. So these two pieces couldn't be any different from each other. We hope you enjoy them. Thank you.
Thank you. Udese, Udipa, Vila, Gesti, Re, Gesti, La, Tese, Tadim, Fusi, Vila, Gesti, Re, Gesti, La, Udese, Fusi, Vila, Gesti, Re, Gesti, La,
composer. This piece is not in print. It was commissioned. I'm a little out of breath. I should probably condition more. The Shehecheyanu is written by Glenn Rudolph, who's a Pittsburgh-based composer. It was commissioned by the Westmoreland Choral Society many years ago. And it's in three sections. It's also an A, B, A. And it was written for Vera Altresh, and the B section features Vera's theme. Our soloist this evening is Connor Taha, senior. About 6 minutes and 40 seconds.
Thank you.
the first set with Baba Tandaza, which is actually a South African folk song. So, now, guys, are you ready? No, they've made a wall ball. Anything, they got me anything? You guys ready? Did you go to wall ball? No. I'm actually a frustrated stand-up comedian. Terrible at it.
Thank you. Bobby Sienna, Abby Kelly, and Sophie Sienna. I hope you enjoy.
Second eye, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom, getting higher than the actor's state. My love, she's waiting for me. Just across the bar, my seat's been taken to buy some sunglasses. Asking how the scar went, I know I gave it to you months ago. And I know you're trying to forget, but I think the truth of something. I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home.
Thank you.
just a little bit about this next group you're going to hear, the vocal ensemble. It's an audition group. We meet during lunch and learn. So we meet during two lunches in a weekly cycle. And these kids, it's an audition group. They elect to be there to learn more and challenging music. So we are actually going to present to you Seasons of Love from Rent. And that was Jonathan Larson, 1996. And then Sing Sing Noel, the French Carol. And we're actually going to be featuring Miss Teresa Joseph, who is actually one of our very own music teachers here in Marbella. All right. Teresa, you have a fan club out here already. She's backstage warming up, I assure you. All right. Vocal ensemble, are you ready? Thank you. I often get questions like, is your choir audition?
No.
It's actually not. So we welcome anybody in grades 9 to 9 through 12. If they have a desire to sing, if they want to be part of something special, we meet anybody anywhere they're at in their journey in making music. This year we have about 73 singers on our roster, but we don't always get to meet all together. We meet in smaller class cohorts. And there are some really nice things about that. We can get to know each other more individually. We can get more individual vocal attention. So those aspects of the class are really, really nice. We do come together as sections during lunch and learn periods. But the one thing I want to say, whenever we rehearse in the classroom, we've been sitting in a circle around the piano. And I want to say a couple of things about that. Number one, when you sit in a circle, everybody is of the same importance. And that's really important. I always say to these kids, it doesn't matter where you're at on your musical journey. Like, we're not always going to be the same level musically or vocally as some of our friends. What matters is most is that you're making the best contribution that you can right where you are. And that's what this is all about. That's what we're about. That's what we strive for. I think you guys are doing it. I think you're fantastic. I think you're one of the strongest guys. One of the strongest choirs we've had. The piece that we did previously, the Shahekeanu, I won't always program that piece because it requires so much heart. And I'm not sure heart and passion can be taught. I know it can be modeled, but I don't think it can be taught or evaluated as such. And I knew that they would be able to bring that together. So we're going to sing about light next. And so, I love all of these things in life, light, color, all of those things. And now that we have less sun, you may notice that the light is different in the morning, and it's different at night, as opposed to when it is in the summertime. And so, this is, while it's the darkest time of year, it does offer some of the prettiest light. And so, Jacob Navarrete has written this beautiful song, which they actually did not like at first, called Season of Light. How do you feel about it now? Do you like it better? I think it's beautiful. Enjoy.
Thank you.
beautiful.
So now we're going to radically change gears, and we're going to go to one of my favorite Christmas songs ever, by Jerry Herman, Maine, 1966, We Need a Little Christmas. And Angela Lansbury originally played the role, but in the movie, it was Lucille Ball. Not sure if you knew that, raise your hand. It was Kristen, of course. Yes, of course, Lucille Ball. So here we go, We Need a Little Christmas. We welcome Julian for the drum kit. So if you've noticed that we have everything up here but the kitchen sink, right? We have an electric piano, a Steinway piano. Now we're going to welcome our Harrington Orchestra, and we're going to do two numbers combined for you. The first one is When You Believe from The Prince of Egypt, and the second is the Hallelujah Chorus from Handel's Messiah. Thank you.
So it has come to that time of the program where we've established, we're trying to establish this tradition where we're going to perform the Hallelujah Chorus. We're actually doing it tomorrow at the administration building with Lower Merion High School Choir and Orchestra. We're going to combine both choirs and both orchestras in admin to perform for our new superintendent. So we're looking very forward to that. But tonight, we're going to invite any of our music teachers that are in the house to come up and sing with the choir if they would like to. I know Miss Joseph is going to play with the orchestra, so if you're out there, Miss if I saw you, if you want to come up and sing with the choir, we'd love to have you up here. And if you don't, let's get into the fight. So we have Miss Callahan from Welsh Valley Middle School. And Mr. Hunter from Lower Merion High School.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for sticking around. Have a round of applause to Harry and Dad. So, that first piece was an arrangement of the tune I Thought About You by Vernon Steeler, which arranged for the University of North Texas, which is one of the premier jazz programs in the country. And to jump from jazz program to jazz program, this next piece, Lush Life, has a lot of deep importance to me on many levels. First of all, the composer, Billy Strayhorn, is a fantastic, fantastic composer. He was Duke Ellington's right-hand man. But this is a piece that I love personally and was taken from the album This Side of Strayhorn by my professor from college, Terrell Stafford. And that's where the beginning of this arrangement came from. And as soon as I heard it, I recognized it. And I wanted to give a chance for these students to be able to share this piece like I did. So without any further ado, this is Lush Life.
Thank you.
restaurants. Every year at Harry, there's an activities fair, and usually we get the kids who play bass, we play guitar, piano, trumpet, saxophone, all the normal instruments in jazz bands. And sometimes some extra ones, like the odd flute player who wants to join jazz bands. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't, but this is the first time in a long time that someone came up to the table and said, I'm a singer, I want to do jazz bands. So I thought, huh. I played with plenty. I never directed one. Kind of fun. So we talked back and forth a little bit about background, and it ended up being a perfect match. And so, for what I think is the first singer in Harrison's jazz history, please welcome Miss Sydney Halley. She's going to be singing two songs with us. This first one is Do Nothing Till You Hear From Me.
You are the one.
visit and the outstanding. Are for sale at the concert. So, if you would like one to take home, Mr. Visage, I don't know where you are. I forget what the prices were. Oh, up there. Hi, it's down the Waldorf. How are you? Remind me, shout it down. Poinsettias are how much? There we go, it's in the program. One for 20 and two for 35. There's a Venmo code if you want to pay for Venmo, or if we have some wonderful students that will be willing to take your money, absolutely, if you want to buy one. We'll have a couple people stationed up here. Our last song is a John Coltrane piece called Moments Notice. Playing the role of John Coltrane tonight is going to be Jeremy Green on the tenor sax. I just slipped my mind in concert mode. A couple solos I forgot to recognize in the moment. On our first piece, we had Tommy Lynch, who's now sitting. We also had Alex Siciliano leading the part on left side. So this is our last one, Moments Notice.